Now, before proceeding further, I just want to organize these objects and sprites. So I will right click on sprite and I will create a group, and I will name this group buttons. Click OK, and I will drag these two buttons. I will just drag this one into buttons, and I will drag the exit into buttons folder. And same as I will do in the objects, right click on it, create group, and I will name buttons. Okay, and I need to drag start button into it and exit button into it. And I will save this project, and I just want to run this up to check if the buttons are at the correct position or not. So these are at the correct position. Now the next thing that I want to do is I want to add a click event on this start or a touch event on any mobile device or any touch device. When I will touch it, it should navigate to the next screen, and the next screen where I will add a new object, and that object will ask me to pop that balloon. I need to pop that balloon to navigate to my gameplay area, but that's we'll do later. First I need to add a click event on this start. So to add a click event, we need to create a room, because whenever we will click on it, we need to navigate to another room. So that's why we are going to create another room, and I'm going to go to settings, and I will name this room pop room, and the width and height should be same, because the same game would be running on any particular device. All the screens would be of the same size. So I will add 768 width, and height is 1024. This is the width and height. Okay, so now I will add a background same as we did. So add a background. Background have been added. Let's go to objects, and inside the objects, let's add our ground. All right, so we have added our ground. We have to add another object, and that object will be having a pop me written on it, but I haven't added in the sprites folder, so I can't add it directly from here, because I need to add it in the sprites folder and the objects folder. Let's leave it as it is. I just want to show you the navigation for now. Okay, and once the navigation works, we will come back to this room and add those objects on it. So let's click on this arrow icon to save this room. Click on it. Now this is the button. Okay, if I double click on it, it's showing me two windows right here. One is the events window and other is the action windows. And in the events window, I need to add different events. You can see that there is a button at the bottom. If I click on it, it has opened up a new window, and on that window I have different kinds of event that I can add. I can add a create event whenever this object is created, what we want to do. Whenever this object is destroyed, what we want to do. So all these events. Right now I want to add a mouse event, and the mouse event in Game Maker Studio is same as a touch event on any touch device. Okay, so when I click on it, it's showing me all the mouse event that I can use to work with. So right here I can add a left pressed event. The left event is the touch event on the screen device. Okay, so whether it's a left pressed, left button, left released. Okay, so I want to add an event left released. I don't want to navigate to next screen just by touching that button, start button, but whenever I want to leave or release that particular object, a start button, then I want that game to navigate to next screen. So I want to add this event left release. This event have been added, and on the right side I have the actions. Whenever I will select any particular event, it will show me all the actions that are belonging to this event. Okay, so right now I haven't added any actions. Whenever the left button is released, what are the actions that I want to perform? I want to navigate to the next room. Okay, so to navigate to the next room, you can see that there are different options. I can also add a script, but right now I just want to show you a built-in tools inside it. So if I click on this main one, I hope that you are looking on it, the second tab right here, and I have this rooms area. Okay, I can go back to the previous room, I can go forward to the next room, and I need to click on it and drag it right here. Okay, so you can see that this action have been applied to this event. Now I need to give it a new room, that which room I want to navigate to. So the start page contains the start button, so I don't want to navigate to the same room where I'm already in. I want to navigate to the pop room. Okay, so I'll click OK. So this action have been applied to this event. All right, so for now let's check it out if it's navigating to our next page or not. So I need to click on this OK. I'm saving this project and I will play this game. So I have just clicked on it, and whenever I will release it, I want this to navigate to our next page. Okay, so you can see that I have released my button. It has been navigated to my next screen. This is the pop room. So our click event is working fine. Now I need to design this room a bit, but before that I need to bring those sprites inside this room. So I will create a new sprite, load sprite, and inside it I want this one. Okay, and let's add pop balloons sprite. Alright, let's click on the center to bring the origin to the center and click OK. Now let's create another one, load sprite, and this one. Okay, pop me sprite, and let's click center. Okay, so we have added our two objects inside sprite folder. Now we need to add those objects, those sprites, in our objects folder. So right click on it, create object, and I will click on it. You can see that we have a pop balloon sprite and a pop me sprite. Let's click on it and I will click OK. Okay, let's double click it, and I want to rename it pop obj, pop me. Okay, so I need to click OK. I need to create another object, and this time pop balloon sprite pop obj. Alright, let's click OK. So now I need to go to my pop room, and let's cross this up, make it a bit larger. Let's bring it to the center, and I'm in the objects tab, and I will select pop me object, and I will click I'll click right here, and I will drag it here. Okay, so that has been added. Now I will select this pop object, just create right here and drag it right here. This is just for designing purpose. You can design it in your own way. I'm just designing it in a way, whenever I'll click on start button, it should navigate to this room, and whenever I'll click on this pop me balloon, it will pop up, show the animation of popping up the balloons, and I will navigate to the gameplay screen. Alright, so that has been added. Let's click on this tick icon, and I will save my project, and I will run this up to see if it's working fine or not. Okay, so that has been started. Let's click and release the start button, so you can see that we have been navigated to our pop underscore room screen. Alright, so that's been done. Now next, I want to have some animations inside it. I'm not going to go my gameplay area right now, but there are some animations. The clouds should move from the right side to the left side. It should keep on generating inside it, and I have to add the small balloons coming out from these greenish area and going upward. Okay, so these are the animation I need to add in this room and in this room, and that will help you to understand how we can write scripts, how we can write controllers. So let's get started and create those animations. Now I want to add clouds behind this logo, and I want that clouds to have animations and movement towards the left side, and I want clouds to generate itself again and again from the right side and move towards left side. So in that case, I will add my controller, because anything that is not in the screen, but I want that thing to generate itself once we start our game, that needs to have controller. Okay, so first I will add a sprite of my cloud, and I will load a sprite, and this is the cloud, and I will open this up. Okay, so I will name it cloud. I will change the origin to center and I'll click OK. Alright, so cloud has been added. Now I will right click on object, create object, and I will select that cloud and I will change its name obj underscore cloud. Okay, so I'll click OK. So now if I right click or a simple left click on it, I can see that I have the cloud, and I have the start page open, and I can select obj cloud and I can click on it, and I can just set it right here. Okay, let's make it a bit bigger. All right, and I will click it and I will play my game. There will be no animation for now because I need to add few more things inside. You can see that we have clouds at the back side. Now I will just move this particular cloud towards left side. I'm not going to generate new clouds, but I just want to show you how we can navigate an animation to these clouds. So I'll open the start page. Let's close this up. And I will open this obj cloud object. Alright, I need to add event, and if I click on it, I can see that I have create event. It means that whenever that particular object is created, what I want to do. So I will add a create event, and I will go to my control, and inside the control I have this particular file type of icon, and inside this file I can write my code, and that code will be following the JavaScript syntax. So I will drag this inside it. Okay, so whenever our object will be created, what I want this thing to do. So inside GameMaker Studio, we have built in keywords that we can use for the animations, for the movement, for destroying object, for creating object. So for movement, horizontal movement, we have h speed keyword. Alright, and h speed means that if we give it a negative value, our particular object where we are applying this event, in this case we have obj underscore cloud, whenever I will give it a negative value, it will move towards left side, and whenever I will give it a positive value, it will move towards right side. So I'm giving it minus 2 because I want my clouds to move so slowly towards left side. So I will take on it. Okay, so I'll click OK and I'll save my project, and I will just see and check this out if it's working fine and moving towards left side or not. Okay, so you can see that we have clouds, it's moving towards left side with the speed of minus 2. But there is another thing. Whenever our cloud will be moving towards left side, whenever it will go out of screen, I want these clouds to be destroyed itself, because in our game, our processor, the RAM of our mobile phones, the desktop, we don't want these clouds to generate again and again and occupy the space inside the RAM. And whenever these clouds move out of screen, I want these clouds to be destroyed itself, because I don't want those clouds to occupy space. I just want those clouds which we can just see on our screen to have a space occupied inside the RAM. So I'll just open this up and I will add another event. Okay, and in our case we have a step event. Step event, we have, let's click on it, step event, and what step event will do, it will run 30 times a second. We don't need to do anything. It will run 30 times a second, and it will check that if the clouds have been gone. It depends on our code that what we want to do. So let's go to our control and bring the script inside it. So inside it, what I want to do, I want this step event to check if our clouds have been gone out of screen or not. Okay, so to do that, I can write if and I can use X word or Y word. X stands for position, horizontal position, okay, and Y stands for vertical position. So the horizontal movement can be identified with the X, and a vertical position can be identified with the Y. Okay, so I will add an event if X is less than minus 300. Okay, means if the X position of my cloud is less than minus 300, means that our cloud have gone out of screen towards left side. The width of my cloud is 400. I'm just testing this out and adding this out. 300 over origin is set to the center. So if I write minus 200, it will work even then. But I want this thing to be destroyed way out of screen. All right. So what I want to do, if it goes out of screen, means the X position is less than minus 300. Then I want to destroy this event, and I can use another function built in GameMaker function, that is instance underscore destroy. Okay, it will be automatically applied to the object which we have just opened. We have opened obj underscore cloud, so this instance destroy will only be applied on this particular object. Okay, so we are done with our, this is a very good practice for the best performance of our game, because without destroying any object that is not in the screen, it will create a lot of problem in the performance of your game. So I'll just click on it. Now I need to generate clouds from the left side and from the right side and move towards the left side, and for that I need to add a controller. So first I will add a group, because I need to add a lot of controllers in my game. So I will just add a folder controllers, and inside this controller I need to add a controller for generating our clouds. Okay, so I will just right click on it and I will create object. So I will name this object, let's say that we have cloud creator. Okay, so how we can create a controller? Whenever we will not select any sprite from here, it will already be, it will become a controller. So there is no sprite selected. So if I click OK, you can see that there is a white icon right here. It means that it doesn't belong to any particular sprite, but it can be applied to any object through script. Alright, so whenever we want to generate anything on runtime, whenever we want to play the game, then that needs to have a controller to generate that thing and for the actual movement of that object. Okay, so I will just open this up. Okay, so inside it I need to have a few objects. Okay, so few objects and a few events. If I click on the add events, you can see that I have a create event. And what I want to do after the creation of this controller, let's add a create event. Okay, so inside the control, let's drag this code, and inside it I want to use an array object inside GameMaker Studio that is called alarm. And alarm is an array. We can have more than one alarm, but for the cloud generator we can have just one alarm, and that can be identified with the zeroth index. So I'll give it a value 100. Okay, I'll explain you what does it mean. Just click on this tick icon. I will add another event, and that would be alarm, and I will select alarm 0 because I added alarm 0 and give it a value 100. So I need to add alarm 0, and I will add a script to it, and inside it I want to generate clouds for a particular event, particular number of times. Okay, and after specific time. So whenever I want to create, if I say alarm 0 equals to 200, 200 means if I divide 200 by 30, and that would become something like 6 point something. So Let's say that it is 6, okay? So 6 means 6 seconds. This alarm 0 equals to 200 means that this is going to be executed every 6 seconds. This script is going to execute every 6 seconds. Whenever a cloud will be created, this script will execute, and this will execute the alarm 0 script after about 3.3 seconds, because 100 divided by 30 is 3.3 approximately. So this script will call alarm 0, and inside the alarm 0 we have another script, and inside this script we are calling our own script after every 6 point something seconds. Okay, so we need to call it again and again for generating the clouds again and again from the right side. Okay, so I hope that you have got the idea. Now inside it, whenever this will call itself again and again, what I want to do after that, I want to create clouds from the right side, and we have already applied the movement in my cloud object. Okay, so for creating our instance, we have a built-in function inside GameMaker Studio, and that is called instance underscore create. Alright, and the first parameter, it contains three parameters. The first parameter is the x value, and the second parameter is the y value, and the third parameter, that which object we want to create. So first of all, whenever this object will be created, what should be the starting x position of this object? Okay, so starting x position should be out of screen towards left side. Okay, so if I generate clouds on my screen, it will not create a good impact on our users who will play our game. I want this object, so I will call room width plus 200. Room width will identify the device where we are running our game, whether it's a desktop, whether it's a mobile, whether it's a mobile device or a tablet. Each device have different dimensions. So we need to call this function to identify the width of our screen at runtime, and I'm adding up 200 because I want this cloud object to generate out of screen towards right side. Okay, so now I need to add its Y position. I want my clouds to generate not from the same Y axis position, but I want these clouds to generate randomly at different position. If I open the start page, let's just minimize it. Okay, we have this script. I want my clouds to generate from this position or from this position, from the upper position, but I don't want my clouds to go below this greenish area. Okay, so I need to apply a random function that identify a random position, Y position yourself. Okay, so I click on it, where it's gone. Let's open this up again, controller, alarm, and this one. Okay, so it's showing me error. I need to give its Y position, so I can call the random 150. So this function will generate numbers from 0 to 150 itself. Okay, and after that, let's add a constant value to it. So we have set our X position and Y position, and the third parameter is which object we want to generate. We want to generate obj underscore cloud. So obj underscore cloud. Alright, so obj underscore cloud, whenever this function will create that particular object, and inside that object I have already added animations. Okay, whenever this object will be created, this script will be executed, and it will have h speed that is -2. Okay, so that has already been executed. Okay, so let's save all these scripts. Alright, so now the last thing that we need to do right here, in order that controller, how does that controller, that in which page, in which room I need to create cloud? Alright, we also need to tell this GameMaker Studio that this is the room in which you should create new clouds. Okay, so I will open up this start page, All right. And if I just click on it, you can see that I have a controllers folder, and inside it I have this cloud underscore creator. All right. If I click on it, and I need to click anywhere inside the screen. Okay. So if I click right here, you can see that there is a small icon, a question mark icon. And if I hover my cursor on it, you can see that right here it will show me the name of that particular object. So it's showing me cloud underscore creator. So this controller have been added inside this room. It means that this controller now knows that it should create new clouds, new objects. It should apply all these events, execute all these events inside that particular room. Okay, so I will just save this one. So I will run this up, and you can see that it is moving. Now our new clouds should be generated from the right side. So you can see that our clouds are generating from the right side, and it will keep on generating every 6 seconds, because I'm calling alarm zero array every 200 times. 200 means 200 divided by 30, and the value becomes seconds. Okay, so our clouds are moving perfectly. Now we need to add the animation on the back balloons, which I will just do it in a hurry, because you have got the idea how you can add animations in different objects. Okay, so I need to add few more balloons inside it for their animation coming out from this greenish area and going upward to make this game a kind of more attractive. If I click on it, you can see that there is no cloud inside it because I haven't added my controller inside it. If I want to generate clouds inside it, how can I do it? Just do that. So pop room, open the pop room and just make it a little bit bigger. At start I will add a cloud. Okay, so I have added this cloud. All right, and if I want to generate my clouds again and again, what I need to do? I just need to add a controller, and the controller will already know that I need to create clouds in this room as well. So I will just go to controller, cloud controller, and I will click right here. So this controller have been added inside this room as well. All right. So, and this object already know that I need to execute these script. All right. So let's save this up, and I will play this one. And if I click on start, you can see that the clouds are moving inside it, and I want new clouds to be generated from the right side. So you can see that what is the benefit of creating controllers. These objects are generating at runtime. So anything that has to be generated at runtime should have a controller. Alright, so these will executing, and whenever it will go outside of the screen, I have added a step event inside the cloud object that you need to destroy yourself. I don't want those objects to occupy space in the RAM if you go out of the screen. Okay, this is the step event, and if you go out, instance underscore destroy. So we are done with it. Now let's add a few more back balloons object, the smaller balloons, and that should come out of this greenish area. So that will be the last step of this design of this room, and after that I will come back to my gameplay area, gameplay room. Now I'll right click on sprite, create sprite, and I will create all those 3-4 sprites that need to be generated as a smaller object. So I will load sprite, and I need to find sprite 18, this one. Alright, so leave it. Let's add the center, create another load sprite, and I will add sprite 20 center. And I'm going to add the last one, and that would be Let's add this one. Okay, so I think these are pretty much fine. I need to generate these four sprites, so I'll click OK. But first I will create a group and I will change its name to back balloons and I'll click OK. So I will just drag all these sprites inside this folder. Alright, so now I need to create objects out of all these sprites. So I'm going to just right click and create back balloons sprite. Alright, so now I need to give it names. I'll give it B1. So click OK. Create another. Actually, this is not. Let's delete it. Let's first create a folder back balloons. Click OK and I will drag B1 inside this. Alright, so I will right click back balloons and I will create object and I will back balloons sprite 8 and I will name it B2. Okay, so same as for other two, B3. Okay, create and B4. Alright, so we have created all these objects of all these sprites. Now we need to add animations and add the controller so that these objects may generate from that downside. Okay, so first what I need to do, I need to add an animation to it and then I will generate other balloons from the bottom. Alright, so first I'll open B1 and I will add an event. When it will create, let's go to control, drag the script, then I want it to move towards upside and I can control it with the V speed, that stands for vertical speed, and I will give it -1. -1 means move towards upside, and positive value given to the V speed means move object towards downside. Alright, same as we did in cloud, we gave horizontal speed and we gave -2 as a value to that variable. Okay, again I will click on it and I will add a step event. Step event runs 30 times a second. Alright, so I need to check if that particular object go y is less than, let's say, -50. Alright, then this should destroy, instance underscore destroy. Alright, whenever our particular object B1 will go out of screen, means go up, then this particular instance will be destroyed and this function will be applied to that object that is just being opened. Okay, so I will just click on this one. Actually I'm going to delete B1 to B2 to B4 because I will duplicate B1 because I have added few events and actions. I don't want to add all these things again and again for others, so I will just right click B2 and delete this one, right click B3, delete this one as well, delete this one as well. Alright, and I'm going to right click B1 and I'm going to duplicate it and I'm going to change its name B2 and I'm going to select the sprite 8. Okay, so all these events and actions will be already applied to the other objects. So I'll click OK. You can see that it has been applied. So I'll right click B2, duplicate, and I just need to change the object sprite 8 and I'll change its name to B3. The last one, let's duplicate this one and select sprite 10 and B4. Alright, so I have added a code inside it. Now let's first add, let's add a default balloons inside it. Let's add right here, let's add B2. Okay, drag it right here, Let's select B3 and I'm going to write here, okay? And the last one is B4. I'm not clicking directly inside it because there is a problem, because in my bottom image, this is the ground image, the tree greenish area, that is covering the whole area of screen. So if I click on it, it's gonna select that particular object, that particular greenish area. Okay, so let's try to do it. If I click on it, you can see that that object have not been added because it has selected the, if I click on it, it has selected the bottom area because it covers a lot of area of screen. So that's why I was creating that particular object outside the screen and then I was dragging it inside. So I need to select B4 and now I'm going to draw it outside and then I will drag it back right here. Okay, so we have added all four objects. These objects will move upward, but the new objects will not be created yet. I need to create a controller for creating those objects, four objects randomly, and their movement will be automatically applied to it because the movement is applied on individual particular object. So I'll click on this tick icon and I'll save my project and I will run this game to see if those objects moving upward or not. So you can see that those objects are moving upward and the clouds are also generating. Now I need to add a controller to generate these objects again and again from the bottom and it will automatically move towards up. Okay, so movement is applied on that particular object. We don't need to control the movement. We just need to add a controller for the creation of objects. Okay, so now let's add a controller. Open the objects folder and inside the controllers folder, I'm going to create object without selecting any sprite and I'm going to name it back balloons controller. All right, so inside it, I need to add a create event, and inside the create event, let's go to control tab and I will drag the code right here and I will first call my first alarm event. Okay, inside the create event I'm going to call the alarm 0, so alarm 0th index, and I want to call it after 1 second. Okay, 30 divided by 30 is 1, so I'm calling alarm 130, but there is no alarm 0 inside this event. I need to create alarm 0 as well. All right, so I will click on it and I will create alarm 0 and I will drag the code inside it, and I need to call this alarm 0 script again and again because I want to generate those four objects from the bottom again and again. So after how much time I want to create those particular objects, let's say I want to create individual object after about 5 seconds, so what divided by 30 becomes 5, it's 150, so alarm 0 equals to 150. So it's gonna call itself after every 5 seconds, okay, because 150 divided by 30 is 5. Now I need to add a random function to find out that which object has to be created first. So our game maker script, this script will automatically identify that which object should generate and which object should generate afterwards. So I'm going to call a random function inside it. Okay, so let's add a global keyword, which balloon, and floor random 5 4. All right, because we have four objects, what it's gonna do, it's going to generate number from 0, from 1 to 4. All right, and when I will have 1, I will generate B1, when I will have 2, I will generate B2. So with this variable, I will identify that which object should I create. All right, and the global before a variable name means that this variable can be used in the scripts of other objects. All right, if I don't write global inside it, I need to write var before it. And this particular variable can only be used inside this script. It can't be used outside this script, even in other events scripts or in other objects scripts. So I need to add global keyword because I want to use this particular variable in other scripts as well. Okay, so global dot x position equals to random 600 plus, let's say, 84. Okay, so what it's doing, I want my objects to generate not at the same x position. All right, I want my object to be generated, let's say that from left side, from the middle of screen, from the right of the screen. So that's why I have added applied a random to 600, because the width of my screen is 768 and I have added 84 into it as well, so it's not going to going out of my screen. So this variable will contain, let's add global. All right, so now I need to identify that this function have generated which number. Okay, so I can add if global dot which balloon, if it's generate 0, all right, then I want to add instance underscore create, all right, and I need to give it x position, and x position is being identified with this variable, so I can simply give it x underscore p o double s. I have added double s because x underscore pos is a built-in keyword, so I can't use this one. So now I need to give the height. First I can detect the height with the help of room underscore height to find out the height of device in which we are running this game, and after that I am dividing it by 300. Okay, so which object I want to create? I want to create B1 when which balloon will have zero as a value inside this variable. So let's end this if block. Alright, so I'm going to copy this one and paste it again, and I'm going to add else before it. Alright, and I'm going to check if it's 1, 2, 3. Alright, and when it's 1, I want to generate B2, B3 and B4. Alright, so every time any this particular variable will identify that which object has to be generated. Alright, so that's been done. Now I need to add this particular controller inside my screen. So let's open it up and save this up. This is the script and I'll click OK. So this is the controller. All right, now I'm opening the start page, and from here I'm going to select that controller and I'm going to add that controller inside my room. So you can see that I have added this controller inside my room. So because I want to tell GameMaker that you need to use this controller to generate the back objects on this room. All right, whatever we write in our script, that will be applied to this room as well. Okay, so let's open it up. I'm going to save my project and let's run it. So you can see that these objects are being generated. It has been generated, it has been generated as well. All right, but the problem is that these objects are generating above this greenish area. I want these objects to be generated behind these greenish area, so I need to add depth inside it. Okay, so let's open this up and I will add 100 to it. Open this up, add 100 to it as well, to B3 and to B4 as well. So I'll save this now. Okay, I have added 100 because it should be greater value than the object where we want to hide this one. Ground object have 50, so I needed to add a greater value than the depth of this ground one. Okay, so I will run this now. So you can see that these are coming behind this greenish area because I have added depth to these object. Alright, so these objects. Now let's add controller to our pop room as well, because I want these balloons to come out from back balloons controller. Let's add the controller to this one. Okay, so let's save my project. I'm going to run this again and let's click start, and I want those objects to be generated on this room as well. So let's see if these generates or not. So you can see that these objects are generating from the bottom and going towards upside. Alright, and when these will go at the top and will go out of screen, these objects will be destroyed. Alright, so I hope that you have got the idea. There is nothing more from now, but when I will click on it, it will add an animation that it will generate, and it will look like that balloon have been popped up. And when I'll click on it, we will navigate to our gameplay area where we will have to pop the balloons, and that will be the actual task of this particular tutorial. And then there will be more things to add up, like scores and game pause and resume. So let's go and create a new room for our gameplay area.